entourage arrived in Tirupati to thank the gods for the creation of Telangana. He brought with him gold ornaments worth 5.5 crore rupees, including a 14.2 kilogram gold necklace worth 37 million rupees. However, his prayers have triggered a controversy, with many questioning why he was burdening the public exchequer and spending taxpayer money to fulfill a personal vow. Big controversy in Telangana, with the Congress and the BJP both attacking KCR.
The work of the people is the work of God. So I think if he understands that when he does work for the people and does work sincerely for the people, that is in essence doing what God wants him to do. So without going to temples and giving money, this is something which I think as a chief minister, with a little bit of common sense, I think it would appeal to everybody that if he does the work of the people sincerely and diligently, then I think he would be representing God in their lives.
He is donating some gold, 5 crores of gold worth is presenting. But my appellation, whether he want to do it, any God give something to God, it is own money, not public money. If the public money was paid by the tax amount, various people has given, the government, they are spending tax and everything they are collecting. On that money he is spending, it is not correct. Even God also will not help on this thing. If anybody, they want to donate to God, it should be the own money.
There are two reasons to it, and that should be put on record. First of all, do we, in the age of scientific temper, how do we analyze persons like KCR? I mean, your state is really under crisis, and you have the audacity to indulge in that kind of splurge. Nothing can explain that, number one. Number two, scientific temper is also part of your constitution. I think, where are we heading, Mr. Chief Minister? You have important things to address.
As of now, totally he's failed. He's not even concentrating on his promises. Moreover, he's trying to bulldoze, and he tried to ride over all the opinions of the oppositions. So we are not asking any new demands. We are not asking any new issues. Whatever the issues, whatever the promises you made, whatever the things are you mentioned in the manifesto, only those things we are asking. Not immediately we are asking, after 33 months we are asking. So 3 years, what is the progress?
It is not sending the money from the exchequer. It is spent from the common good fund. What is common good fund? Common good fund is the funds that people give in the temple. 5% of it is taken by a particular fund managed by the endowment department. It has nothing to do with the government at all. This year, I am now just now told, government has agreed to give matching grant, matching funds, so that same thing can be used. So it is a public fund. It has nothing to do with any budgeted funds at all, till recently. So this fund has to reflect the people's needs as far as the offerings to God is concerned.
When Congress has left Telangana, formed Telangana state, in 60 years of Telangana existence, we had a debt of about 60,000 crores. In 3 years, without any tangible developmental projects, this man has pushed the Telangana state to 1,20,000 crores of debt. Which means in 3 years, 60,000 crores of new debts he has created. Now what for? It's all callous governance, irresponsible governance, dictatorial governance, and unconstitutional governance is going on in Telangana. Surely people will teach him a lesson.
It's a creation of asset to the state. It is not for his own sake, or he has not used it for his own. He has created an asset to the state. And again, the amount they are exaggerating, it's about 100 crores what they are saying, is of nonsense. Actually, I being an architect, I practiced here for 30 years, I will tell you, if any of those opposition leaders come forward and pay me 50 crores, I'll construct the same house and give them. Even then, I'll get a lot of money. So, just by putting a lot of stones on the ruling party, it will not be considered.
This is not the first time he has done this in Yadagiri Gutta and Bhadrachalam, and even in Bhadrakali temple in Warangal. crores of rupees of taxpayers' money, spending as if his own personal property, it is not only unethical, unconstitutional, it is amount to be a criminal offence. Chief Minister has no right to spend money like this. We need to look into the, not as an emotional issue, I think opposition should fight to the legally and to the public.